Good afternoon, my dear students. Welcome to Lalisar Chemistry channel. So today the topic is centripetal force, centrifugal force, Kepler's law and speed. So first of all, we will discuss centripetal force. See, I have an object in my hand, and if I rotate this object like this way, so what happens? So if we see, so these objects that covers a circular path, so this object is bonded with this center. This is the center, and there is a force that is acting inward toward the center that keep to this object in a curved path. That force is called centripetal force, the force that is necessary to keep an object moving in a curved path that is directed inward toward the center of the rotation is called centripetal force. Means while this object is rotating, so a force is acting inward toward the center, of rotation. So these kinds of force is called centripetal force. Same times one force is also, when we are going to rotate this object, so we feel that this object is trying to go out. So there is another force which is working outward from the center, of rotation. That force is called centrifugal force. The apparent force that is felt by an object moving in a curved path that act outwardly away from the center of rotation is called centrifugal force. Means this force is acting outward, means toward the object is acting. So that force is called centrifugal force. So the next topic in this one is, that is Kepler's law. So Kepler's given three laws. So we know that there are planets, and all these planets are revolving around the sun. So sun is in the center. And the planets are revolving around it. Consider here is a planet. So Kepler's given three laws to explain this. So he gave first law, Kepler's first law. This law says that while any planet is revolving around the sun, it makes an eclipse with sun. So sun ke saath kya hota hai, that makes an eclipse structure or eclipse path. This is known as Kepler's first law. The orbit of a planet is an eclipse. So the path on which the planet is revolving, suppose here this is a planet, and it is revolving around the sun. So the path which is created, so this is the orbit. So orbit means the path on which the planet is revolving, that is called its orbit. And when it rotates, so the orbit that created around the sun due to this planet, the shape of that one is eclipse. One of the foci. Kepler's second law says that the line joining to the planet and the sun sweeps equal areas in equal interval of time. Suppose here is a planet. This planet goes from here to there, so that create an area. This one. So and it takes suppose sometimes around 20 minutes. If we are going to consider 20 minutes, so it sweeps some area. Then again here we are going to take the distance between, means that goes from C to D, it also takes 20 minutes. So the area created by CD, that will be equal to area of AB or EF. This is Kepler's second law. The line joining the planet and the sun sweeps equal areas in equal interval of time is a planet that covers same area in same टाइम, सेम टाइम, सेम टाइम। थर्ड लॉ ऑफ कैपिटल इज दैट द स्क्वायर ऑफ द पीरियड ऑफ रेवोल्यूशन मीन्स द टोटल टाइम टेकन, द टोटल टाइम टेकन टू कंप्लीट वन रिवोल्यूशन और रोटेशन अराउंड द सन इज कॉल्ड टाइम पीरियड, टाइम पीरियड अराउंड द सन। सो पीरियड ऑफ रेवोल्यूशन अराउंड द सन इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द क्यूब ऑफ द मीन डिस्टेंस ऑफ द प्लैनेट फ्रॉम द सन। सो व्हाट डिस्टेंस इज ऑफ द प्लैनेट इज फ्रॉम द सन, सपोज हियर इज द डिस्टेंस, सो इट विल बी आर, सो इट विल बी आर क्यूब। सो थर्ड लॉ सेज दैट T square is directly proportional to R cube. This is Kepler's third law. Kepler's third law. The next topic is speed. Speed is what? The rate of change of position of an object, in any direction is called speed. So if we want to denote it by a formula, so speed is equal to distance upon time. Speed, it is a scalar quantity, means it has no direction, but has magnitude, but it has no direction, means it is going in north side or east or west. In which direction the object is going, it does not give any information. That's why it is called scalar quantity. So speed is a scalar quantity. I hope aapko video acha laga hoga. Thank you for watching my video.